Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this topic, I will mainly solve some previous year questions of CSR NET on Slater determinant. This is a very important chapter and question came in each and every year of CSR NET. So watch this video carefully until the end. Now before going to solve the questions, let us have some basic knowledge about Slater determinant. Slater determinant is mainly used to determine electronic wave function for single electron like H2 plus or multi electron system like H2, helium atom, lithium hydride, etc. Now the wave functions derived using Slater determinant must be antisymmetric, and it is a multiplication of space part and spin part. Now since the wave function must be antisymmetric, then we can say if psi space is symmetric, then psi spin part must be antisymmetric. On the other way, if psi spin is symmetric, then psi space must be antisymmetric to fulfill the condition that wave function is antisymmetric. We can say another thing regarding this antisymmetric principle, that if a wave function for a system like this, that is the first electron is in alpha spin and second electron is in beta spin, it is down spin, that means beta, and it is up spin, that means alpha. So the wave function derived by keeping first electron as alpha spin and second electron as beta spin, and if another wave function is derived keeping the first electron as beta spin and second electron as alpha spin, that means first electron is beta spin and second electron as alpha spin, then from the principle of antisymmetric rule, psi 12 must be equal to negative of psi 21. If the wave function is symmetric, then we can write that psi 12 is equal to psi 21. But from the Slater determinant, the determined wave function must be antisymmetric and it will follow this rule. Another thing is necessary for this case, that is the electronic arrangement in Slater determinant must follow Pauli exclusion principle. That means if two electrons resides one atomic orbital, then these two electrons cannot have the four quantum number same. That is, it can have the principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number and magnetic quantum number same, but the spin must be different. That is, spin of first electron cannot be equal to the second electron. If one is alpha spin, the second electron must be in beta spin. It is okay. This is a basic concept regarding the Slater determinant wave function. So let's start the questions. This question came in December 2016 for 4 marks. In the question, it is given that the spatial part of an excited state of hydrogen molecule is proportional to this. Now from this spatial part, using the linear combination of atomic orbital MO approach, we have to say that this spatial part contains only ionic part, only covalent part, both ionic and covalent part, neither ionic nor covalent part. Now to solve such type of question, first of all we have to know what corresponds to covalent part and ionic part. Now here the molecule is H2. If we indicate one hydrogen atom as HA and another hydrogen atom as HB, and the sigma orbital corresponding to this hydrogen atom is sigma G, and corresponding to this hydrogen atom as sigma U. Now if the molecule is covalent, then the two electron of the molecule will be shared by both the atom. That means one electron will reside on one sigma G and the other electron will reside on one sigma U. That means for covalent part, there will be contribution from both sigma G and sigma U as a multiplication. Now on the other hand, if the molecule is ionic, then since from the nature of ionic bonding, either the two electron will reside on HA, that is on sigma G, and for that case sigma U does not contain any electron, and the special part, in special part there will be contribution from only one part, that is sigma G. Since there are two electron, here will be one sigma G and one sigma G. It can be written as one sigma G for first electron and one sigma G for the second electron. Here we can also write as it is as one sigma G for first electron, one sigma U for second electron, or in the reverse way, that was one sigma G for second electron and one sigma U for first electron. Now there is another possibility that the two electron will reside on HB nucleus, that is on one sigma U, and for that special part will be one sigma U 1 and one sigma U 2. There will be no contribution from the one sigma G since no electron present in this orbital. That means we can sum up that for covalent special part, there will be contribution from both the atomic orbital. On the other hand, for ionic special part, there will be contribution from only one atomic orbital, that is either sigma G or sigma U. Now from the given special part, we can see that there is contribution from both sigma G and sigma U, and in this case also sigma G and sigma U. That means in the special part, both part corresponds to covalent part. Now just say that the special part contains one sigma G, one sigma U, and here one sigma G and one sigma G. Then we can say that the special part contains both covalent as well as ionic part, since it will be then one sigma G, one sigma G. But according to the question, the special part is containing only covalent part for both the two terms. That means we can say that the wave function contains only covalent part, and option number B is the correct answer. Is it okay? This question is similar to the previously solved question. It came in December 2014 for 4 marks. In the question, it is given that the Slater determinant corresponding to the ionic part of the ground state valence bond wave function of H2 molecule will be from the given 4 options. Here 1SA alpha, 1SA beta, 1SB alpha, 1SB beta are atomic spin orbitals of hydrogen atoms A and B of the hydrogen molecule. That means 1SA corresponding to the special part and alpha corresponding to the spin part. Now, as I previously told, for hydrogen molecule, if the molecule is ionic, then in the special part, there will be contribution only from one atomic orbital, that is either 1SA or 1SB. And on the other hand, if the molecule is covalent, then the special part will contain contribution from both 1s a atomic orbital and 1s b atomic orbital. Now we have to identify the wave function for ionic part. If we solve the given four wave function, given four Slater determinant, we can found that for the first one, both if we cross multiply both these two and solve this determinant, we can observe that the first wave function, both the electrons resides on the 1sa atomic orbital. If we multiply it as 1sa square alpha 1 beta 2 and 1s square alpha 2 beta 1, and in the special part there will be contribution from only one atomic orbital. That means this corresponds to ionic part. If we solve the remaining three, we can see that for second wave function, in the special part there is contribution from both 1sa and 1sb. That means it corresponds to covalent part. In the third case, there is also contribution from 1sa and 1sb. That is, it is also covalent part. And for the last wave function, this also contributes contribution from both 1sa and 1sb. That means it also covalent part. That means we can say that the first wave function corresponds to the ionic part of hydrogen molecule. So option number A is the correct answer. This question came in June 2017 for 4 marks. From the question you can see that we have to calculate the limiting wave functions of the ground state of H2 plus molecular ion when the internuclear distance separation between these two nucleus goes to infinity and when it is zero. Now let us solve this question. Since H2 plus is a one electron system, now if the internuclear separation between these two nucleus goes to infinity, there is two possibility. One is that HA nucleus remains at a coordinate r and the HB nucleus remains at infinity, and the electron, since it is a one electron system, the electron resides in HA nucleus. There is another possibility that the HB nucleus remains at a coordinate r and HA nucleus remains at infinity. For this case also, the internuclear separation is infinity and the electron resides on HB. Now for this possibility, we have to calculate the wave function. Since it is given as 1sa, 1sb are the wave function of 1s orbital of hydrogen atoms A and B, and 1se is the wave function of the 1s orbital of He plus. This wave function will be needed for the latter case, that is zero internuclear distance. Now for this case, the wave function will be, it is, I am writing it as psi infinity. Infinity denotes to the separation between the two nucleus. Now for this case, since the electron resides on hydrogen atom and HA atom and HB resides at infinity, for this case the wave function corresponds to 1SAR. Similarly, there is another possibility that HB contains the unpaired electron at r coordinate and HA remains as at infinity. So we have to sum up these two wave functions. That is, at internuclear distance, the wave function for this H2 plus case will be 1SAR plus 1SBR. Now if the internuclear separation between these two nucleus becomes zero, it can behave as a helium plus ion, since it is also one electron system. And since for zero internuclear separation, it behaves as helium plus ion, The wave function for this case will correspond to the wave, atomic wave functions of helium plus ion. So for zero internuclear separation, the wave functions will be like this. That means for infinite internuclear separation, the wave function is like this, and for zero internuclear separation, the wave function will be like this. So from the given option, we can see that the option number D is the correct answer. This question came in June 2019 for 4 marks. We have to say the spin wave function for excited helium atom from the given option. Now, in the ground state, the electronic configuration of helium is 1s2. In the excited state, it is 1s1, 2s1. Now, these two electrons in the excited state can be oriented in different way. Like, both are in alpha spin. And for this, the wave function, if we calculate using the secular determinant, it will be like this. 1s1. 2s2 minus 1s2 2s1 into alpha 1 plus alpha 2, and for this excited state the spin part is alpha 1 alpha 2. Similarly, the two electrons can be in beta orientation, and for this the wave function will be like this, and spin part is beta 1 beta 2. Now there is another two possibilities. That is, in 1s the electron is upspin and 2s the electron is downspin. And for this, if we formulate the wave function using secular determinant, it will be like this. And on the other case, the 1s electron can be in beta spin and 2s electron can be in alpha spin. And for this, the wave function should be like this. Since in these two cases, we cannot separate these wave functions in space part and spin part. So, to formulate a wave function that can be separated in separate space part multiplied by spin part, we are just adding and subtracting these two wave functions like this. Now, if we carefully solve this function, we can separate it out in psi space and psi spin part. From this term, we can see that there can be possible two wave functions. That is, I am written here the one wave function of psi 3 prime, which corresponds to, we are taking the minus value, minus factor here, so we have to take the plus factor here. So it is written as 1s1 2s2 minus 1s2 2s1 multiplied alpha 1 beta 2 plus alpha 2 beta 1. And similarly, there is a possibility of another wave function by taking the plus factor of the space function, and subsequently we have to take the minus factor for the spin function, and we can write it like this. For this wave function, for this new wave function, the spin part is this alpha 1 beta 2 plus alpha 2 beta 1, and for this new wave function, the spin part is alpha 1 beta 2 minus alpha 2 beta 1. So the four wave functions corresponding to different orientation in the excited state for helium atom is given here. And from this four wave function, for first, the spin part is alpha 1, alpha 2. For second one, it is beta 1, beta 2. For third wave function, the spin part is alpha 1, beta 1, beta 2 plus alpha 2, beta 1. And the fourth wave function, the spin part is alpha 1 beta 2 minus alpha 2 beta 1. This will be the 4 spin part. Now from the given option, only this option matches with the given with the calculated one. As this is this one, alpha 1 beta 2 plus alpha 2 beta 1. So the option number A is the correct answer for this question. This question came in June 2018 for 4 marks. It is given as, which of these is not a suitable unnormalized wave functions for excited state 1s1 2s1 electron configuration of helium atom? Here it is given as unnormalized because all the 4 wave functions are not normalized since there is no normalization constant. Now we have to identify one wave functions which does not correspond to this electronic configuration of helium atom. Now as I previously derived the 4 wave functions corresponding to the excited state helium atom 1s1 2s1 is like this. This is for this electronic configuration, this wave function corresponds to this electronic orientation, and the last 2 1 corresponds to the these two electronic configuration. As I have derived it previously, just have a look on this. I am writing only the 4 wave functions here like this. It was written as previously derived. Now from this, if we compare these wave functions to the given wave function, we can see that the psi 1, there is no wave functions corresponding to this wave functions in the given option. On the other hand, this psi 2 is similar to the first option, so it is not the correct answer. We have to identify the wave function which is not suitable unnormalized wave functions for this electronic configurations. The second one corresponds to this wave function, the last one. So the second one is also suitable and we have to cancel it out. The third one, alpha 1 beta 2 and beta 1 alpha 2, this corresponds to this third one. So we have to also cancel it out. But there is no wave functions corresponding to such electronic configuration since the fourth wave function is like alpha 1 alpha 2, but it is here alpha 1 beta 2. So this is the wave function that is not suitable for the 1s1 2s1 electronic configuration. So this is the correct answer. You can take a screenshot for these 4 wave functions so that you can compare by yourself. Now this question came in June 2015 for 4 marks. This question is based on the property of a slatter determinant. We have to say the incorrect statement among these 4. Now the first option is a slatter determinant is an anti-symmetrized wave function. It is correct since from the slatter determinant the wave function we calculate is asymmetric or anti-symmetric. So it is not the incorrect option. The second option is electronic wave function should be represented by slatter determinant. It is also a correct statement. For a molecule, the electronic wave function for that molecule we can represent it by slatter determinant. So this is also not correct. I am talking about the fourth option. Later I will say about the third option. In the fourth option, a slatter determinant obeys the Pauli exclusion principle. This statement is also correct since in case of slatter determinant, if we take the hydrogen molecule, if both the electrons reside within one atomic orbital, that is 1sa, then the electron will obey the Pauli exclusion principle, that is the 4 quantum number for the two electron cannot be same. The spin must be opposite for the two electron. If one is upspin, the another will be downspin. So the fourth number statement is also correct. It is cancelled out. Now the third option is a slatter determinant always corresponds to a particular spin state. Now this is not always correct, because as I solved previously for excited state helium atom, as we can see from this that the wave functions corresponding to this spin orientation is like this, and the wave functions corresponding to this spin orientation is like this, and the since these two wave functions cannot be separated into space part multiplication with spin part, we have to added and subtracted both the wave functions to get the accepted wave functions like this, psi 3 prime and psi 4 prime. But none of these wave functions by itself can define this spin orientation. That means I want to say that though these two wave functions corresponds to this and this electronic arrangement, we cannot say correctly that which wave functions corresponds to which spin state, since these wave functions came by addition and subtraction of these two wave functions. We cannot say correctly that this electronic arrangement corresponds to this wave functions or this wave function. Therefore, we can say that a slatter determinant does not always correspond to a particular spin state. So the incorrect statement among the four is this one. Is it okay? This is the last question for this video. This came in December 2019, that is last year CSIR NET for 4 marks. We have to identify the special part of the dominant resonance structure of lithium hydride molecule from the given 4 options. Now, lithium hydride, since electronegativity of hydrogen is greater than lithium, so it generally present in this resonance structure, that is lithium plus H minus. That means it present as a ionic molecule. Since it is a ionic molecule, both the bonding electron will reside on hydrogen atom, and there will be no electron in the valence orbital of lithium atom. Since only the valence part of the wave function is taken into consideration, in the special part of the wave function there will be contribution only from the atomic orbital of hydrogen atom and not any lithium atom. That means we can say that this part, since it contains contribution from lithium atom, this wave function also contains contribution from lithium atom, and this also contains contribution from lithium atom. So we can neglect these three options, since in the wave function only there will be contribution from hydrogen atom, as both the electrons resides on hydrogen atom. So the special part of the wave function will be like this. Since there is two electron, the special part will be like 1SHR1, the coordinate for the first electron, into 1SHR2, the coordinate for the second electron. So the option number D is the correct answer. It is the special part of the resonance structure of lithium hydride molecule. So that's all for this. If you like my video, then please share it and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.